What's up guys, Slasher here, or Hackpot as I'm known on the Sandalar Tribe RP PvP server, where I am protecting the innocent farmer of Hillsbrad against undead mages trying to kill them. So this will be a kind of introduction to PvP, where I'm a level 22 rogue and I fight against two mages. I kill a level 24 pretty quick, and then I have a pretty much one-on-one duel against a level 28 mage. And let's just first watch it, and then I'll break it down, and I'll show what spells are being used. And it's kind of interesting because before I started playing Dota, I actually like had 1.5 years where I did pretty much nothing else but school and World of Warcraft. And I did do a lot of PvP, and I do think that my experiences with World of Warcraft actually made me a better Dota player. So I'm not saying that you can play World of Warcraft now to be a better Dota player, but I think just introduced me to a lot of concepts with how to react to people and stuff like that. And it's actually, World of Warcraft PvP is, in a way, some people on the top level criticize it for being sometimes too simple, but there's a lot of, kind of a lot of depth in it and a lot of stuff you can do. So I do manage to do pretty well against this mage and end up killing him, which is pretty cool when you're level 22. But let's break it down. So first of all, my go-to spell here is Sinister Strike, which is basically my weapon I use, and then plus extra damage, and then I add a combo point to the enemy, and I can add up to 5 combo points, and these combo points can be used for kind of finishing spells, like I have a Eviscerate, which deals more damage the more combo points there is, or there are. But I first take out this mage pretty quickly, and he's already low HP, and this is where I make my first mistake. So I'm a gnome, so I have Escape Artists, which can free me from any immobilizing effect, and I'm freezed here, so I'm thinking, oh, I should use Escape Artist, but it's kind of wasted because I only have 2 seconds left and the other mage is so far away. So this is my first mistake, and it puts me on it puts it on 1 minute cooldown. So his body notices me and decides to come for me, and the first thing he does is he blinks aggressively forwards, and I have marked the enemy spells here in red, maybe too much red, but I apologize for that. But he blinks forward, and he then tries to I stealth actually already here, but since he's so high level, he can still see me. So he tries to hex me, and he uses hex to kind of set up the fight. So when he hexes me, he has all the time in the world to prepare to launch spells at me. But I do manage to get out of his vision, which cancels his polymorph, and I used stealth to do that. And what he then does is that he goes towards me and then use an AoE spell, which is a cane explosion. And the way stealth works in World of Warcraft is that if you take any damage, then you go out of it. So he goes forward and spams the spell to try to get me out of Invis, which works since he hits me there, and since he has got me out of Invis and in melee, in range, then I instantly get a few hits on him. The way this duel works is basically the mage always wants to have distance away from me, and I always want to just be on top of him. So as soon as he's on top of me and he sees me, then he uses Frost Nova, which freezes me in place for up to 8 seconds. And here it would be very nice if I had Escape Artist, because now I'm frozen for 7 seconds. And he's quite close, so I could have definitely used it here if I had it. Instead, he puts out some distance, and you can also see that I'm not the best PvPer yet, or I'm not the best PvPer because I used my mouse, and I should have all the stuff on a what is it called, hotkey. But he uses some distance, or gets some distance, and then he starts to use Frostbolt on me. But I use my Vanish, which is kind of like a way to go into stealth when you are in combat, and that causes him to lose his target, and then he goes forward again with a cane explosion and finds me again, and again I force him to go into melee range with me, and then I can get a few more hits in on him. And then when we are in melee range, then he tries to get out of melee range again. And now he managed to get a hex on me, and then he can use his he can get some distance and then use frostbolt on me, which will damage and slow me. I think this is the first mistake he makes, because you can see here his mana is about 1/3, so it's getting quite low. And later he has a spell that gives him more mana, which is channeling, but he could have used it now and then he would probably have killed me, but he uses it here instead, and he gets 2 frostbolt on me, and now we are melee range, so he wants to get out, and he does that with using the freezing trap again. But I managed to get a gouge on him, and gouge is something someone needs to be facing you, and then you can use it, and he's disabled for 4 seconds, but if you hit him, it's kind of like sleep. If you hit him, he will get out of it. So I use it, and then we are both... I'm frozen in place, and I can't break it now, and he's kind of slept for 4 seconds. And I use the time here, I use it to bandage myself, which I could have used a bit earlier, but it gives me a little more HP, so might as well use the time since I can't do much else. I can't even throw my knife on him because he's too close, and I don't want to hit him right now, because then I'll break to sleep and I will still be frozen. So I use my bandage a bit, and he blinks away, trying to get distance on me. Then he tries to cast a frostbolt, but since it's so far long ago since we actually hit each other, I get out of combat and then I can stealth again. So he can't cast frostbolt, and he's forced to go close to me, and he spams a cane explosion, and he's really using, like, his mana is getting very low. He has about 20% mana, and he's using a lot of mana right now on a cane explosion. So we are melee again, I'm happy for that, and now he wants to get away from me. And you can see I have 5 combo points here, so I can do a finishing move on him and do quite a lot of damage. But he freezes me again. But the more he freezes me, the less well it works. So he started off freezing me for 8 seconds, now it's only 3 seconds. So since he let's go back a bit. So I actually used Escape Artist here, which was a bit fast, but... he freezes me, and now I have Escape Artist up, so I use that, and it buys me a little more time to get closer in on him. And so what he does now is that he uses his Evocation spell, because you can see he's completely low on mana, completely drained of mana, and so he wants to use this for about 8 seconds if he can, and that will give him pretty much full mana. But since I have gotten out of his frost so quickly, I'm able to run to him and gouge him again, and he only managed to get 1 tick off, so he got about, I guess, 25% mana, which is much better than if he had like 100%. So I managed to get a gouge on him, and then I want to wait for my energy to be a full, or be as much as possible. So I want to wait as long as possible while he's still gouged, and then I can use my combo points to damage him. And what I also use here is something called Thistle Tea, which gives me 100 energy instantly, which is full energy. So I use my Eviscerate, and I use Thistle Tea a bit too early. But he starts to try to sheep me because he wants to reset the fight. But I have something called a Kick, which I can use when someone casts a spell. And I want to wait until the very last moment. So I want him to stand as long as possible with his hands like doing nothing, trying to sheep me. And then in the last split second, I want to kick him and then interrupt his sheep. And now he's like, oh, what am I going to do now? And he's kind of panicking, and I managed to finish off level 28, which is quite nice. I am level 22, but I have quite good gear. I don't have like insane gear, but I have good gear for level 22. So, kind of introduction to World of Warcraft PvP, Mage against Rogue. I hope you guys liked it. And if you have any feedback or comments. Yeah. See you guys.